Today we will take a look at tunneling as a problem. And
yes? Sorry? Because it's 1 by t plus log t plus some constant is equal to the same thing. Yeah?
You can just, I mean, you can either put various values of t and see where it comes equal, right? Or the other way is to plot a graph and see where they intersect. Log t versus 1 by t.
You can use any software or calculator, that's fine. Okay. I said graphically or numerically, so either way it's fine. Okay. So to start with, what we'll do is, yeah, I'll take this particle which was moving freely. So I have v is equal to 0, and then I put a wall over here, okay, which is of a certain height v naught. And let me call this as x equals 0. So that's my x direction. So my particle is moving in this particular direction. Okay. Now I already know the solution for v equals 0. Right? If the particle is moving to the right, then I know that it's a e to the power I k x. Okay. Now, if you think of this particle going and hitting the wall, a part of it will also be bounced back. And that would be defined by b e to the power minus I k x. Right? We have seen this when we define momentum. So, the momentum for the first one is h cross k, for the second one is minus of h cross k. What happens when it encounters the wall? That is what we are going to see. So we have a step function now, and we see what happens when it encounters the wall. There can be two cases. One is that the energy of the particle E is greater than V naught. Right? So I throw a ball on the ground, and it bounces above the height of this wall, it goes out, right? If it does not, then it has to come back. So my energy for the moment is above. In a classical case, if the energy, if the height of the ball is above the height of the wall, then the ball is definite to go out. Yeah? In quantum mechanics, that's not the case. Some of it will get reflected back, some of it will go through the wall, above the wall, right? So if this is the case, then I can write wave functions for, let me call this as region 1 and let me call this as region 2, and my energy is above V naught. Then I can write my wave functions, which I can write as psi in region 1 is equal to a e to the power I k x plus b e to the power minus I k x, right? So the wave that is traveling to the right and the wave that is traveling to the left. So the wave that is traveling to the left was not there originally, it came only after reflection. So I don't shoot any particles from the right to the left, only from left to right. And let's call this k1 rather, and define k1 is equal to root 2 m e by h cross. Okay. And in in region 2, so if this particle goes above the step and it goes on the other side, then there is nothing to send it back. There is no more wall. So it will travel only in this direction. So in region 2, what I have is another constant C, e to the power I k2x, where k2 would be defined as root 2n e minus v0 by h cross. E is greater than v0 for this particular case. Then I can define what is how much amount of the wave gets reflected, how much amount gets transmitted. So the total should be conserved, right? Reflection plus transmission should be equal to incident wave. Now we don't have any friction, right? So how do I do that? If I have to worry about reflected wave, for example, so I'll think of total the probability or the intensity of the wave that hits is proportional to a square, right? And the probability that the wave comes back is proportional to b square, right? And if you think about loads and loads of particles, not just one, let's say n naught particles, then the probability of some particles coming back, so the intensity of the particles that's going in is a square times n naught, right? That would be the total number of particles that go in. The number of particles that come back would be b square times n naught. And if I were interested in the number of particles that come back per unit time, then all I have to do is to multiply by their velocities, right? The velocity is nothing but square root of p by m, right? Momentum by m. The momentum I already know, root. So h cross k is the momentum, right? For the free wave, we calculated this, h cross k was the momentum. I operate momentum operator on e to the power I k x, I get back h cross k. So that is the momentum, and which means my momentum h cross k would be root 2 m e. These waves are not bound, they are free. There is no bound, right? So that's my momentum. No. Just see this. It's going to be root 2 ME. No, the K is the same. B is, okay, let me plot these waves. So let's say this is my wave A and that's my wave B. With a smaller amplitude but the same frequency. So with the same wave velocity. Another wave, wave C, would be somewhere over there with a, what do you expect? Lower frequency, higher frequency? Lower frequency. Amplitude would obviously lower than A, so let me call this as A, that is the incident wave, so the amplitude is A, for this one it's B, and the last one C would be a lower frequency wave, so I am just trying to spread it more, and also of lower amplitude, because finally the amplitude, the energy has to be conserved, right? So whatever energy is incident, it is distributed between the one that is going back and the one that is going forward, right? So this is a lower energy, that means a lower frequency wave. The frequency of this, the energy of this is given by 2m e minus v0 by h cross, right? That defines k. So automatically this is a lower energy wave. It's E minus V naught. Yes? If I consider waves of the same energy, if I consider a wave of energy E incident, then this is the wave that transmits is root 2 m E minus V naught. The frequency is of course related to that only. So now I have this. In region 1, K1 is equal to this. So I divide this by m, right? So I guess maybe something, but they are all the same. Yes? So if I have to see that what is the reflection, that is equal to the number of particles that are being reflected per unit time at the boundary, let's say, at x equals 0, divided by the number of particles that are incident per that unit time. So if I see that, then it's just b square. So let me call this velocity in region 1, velocity in region 1. B square by a square, that's it. The velocities are the same. And that's the velocity in region 1. Yes? The total number of particles n on n naught is constant, right? So this is how I would define b square by a square. Reflection. Or reflectivity coefficient, if you wish to call, I don't know. Just reflection. That's the amount of wave. So that is the number of particles that hit the wall and come back. The rest of them get transmitted. So I'll also have a transmission coefficient, which according to the same logic would be c square n naught v2 by a square n naught v1. And these v1s and v2s I can just straightforward replace by k.